So welcome everyone to our monthly Flexi webinar. I hope everyone can see the screen and can hear me loud and clear. Perfect. Hello Rob. So the people from Switzerland, Netherlands. So welcome everyone. So Fernando from Portugal. Hello everyone. Ciao Fabio. Hello Italy. Good, good. So today's Flexi webinar, we will talk and cover white and varnish printing, as well as the layer printing in version 21 in the latest Flexi version. This as well counts for the HP edition, of course. So on the agenda, small introduction, as the webinar, of course, and afterwards we will have the Q&A session. So if you have questions, feel free to ask in the chat box so we can cover those questions. Can be as well another topic or a small question. We can always have a look at it. So in today's webinar, with a small example with a label for a bottle, we will show some white and varnish options. Of course, there are some things we need to highlight, of course. So first of all, for white varnish and layer printing, our printer needs to support those printing methods. So of course, you will need the white channel, the varnish channel, the metallic channel in the device to support the printing methods. Secondly, the correct setup is needed in Production Manager, of course. So if you want to print white and varnish, you will have to make sure you're selecting the white and varnish color modes, as well as some additional spot settings, white settings, and so on. As well as a correct file workflow. So how is the file, how is the buildup of the file? Is this file built up in Flexi or in another design software? Do we import files in Flexi or directly in Production Manager? So those are all parameters which we need to think of. Fourth point, as the user of the machine, we will need the testing workflow, of course. So you'll need some testing on media with the color modes and with the white settings to make sure you will have the output you want to become. And last point, of course, support and feedback. If you have questions or you want extra help setting up a workflow for layer printing, you can always contact your reseller if you're an end user. For resellers, if they want extra information about the white varnish layer printing, contact S International, and we are happy to help you with that. So I have already a question here from Lee. Really want to know how to print 5 layers for a double-sided printing on clear vinyl for window prints. So Lee, which device are you using in this situation? Probably an HP LaTeX. Yes, so the new HP LaTeX 800W, which support the 5-layer double side printing. I have some additional information for this method, which I will provide you at the end of the webinar. So I will note down this topic so we can cover this at the end of the webinar. Okay, so let's start with the example I showed before. So as I said before, there are some different types of workflows to generate a file. In this case, I will import the file in Flexi. So as you can see, a file with some colors, without spot colors in this case, and including a cut contour. I have this file as well in an EPS way. So let's import the file in Production Manager, add. And of course, I'm using a machine which is supporting this white and varnish printing. Just to make sure, I'm using the latest version 21, FlexiSign and Print. For all subscribers, they are free to upgrade their license to Flexi 21. For standard licenses, contact the reseller for the upgrade, of course. So we have our EPS imported in Production Manager. Double click to open the job. As I have a cut contour in the EPS file, which can be previewed in the layout preview, so cut contour preview, you will see a preview of the cut contour. Go back to layout preview. It will add the marks for cutting automatically in this case. So what we need to check is, of course, the color management. So in this case, I don't have a color correction, so I don't have an ICC profile. In all cases, for printing, we advise to use color correction with the, of course, most important one, the color mode for white and varnish printing. So for printing white varnish layers, use color correction, contact the reseller for the ICC profiles. As well, we have a color ICC profile color base. The link is in the chat. Here we have some color profiles for some type of devices, but not for all machines. So please contact the reseller for more information here. So in this case, we are using color mode CMYK, double white, double varnish, as our driver supports double white, double varnish. In the third tab, in the fourth tab, printer options, you will see the additional spot settings and ink settings for the machine. So this is always different for different machines. So if you here go to spot settings, for example, you will see all the different types of white and varnish options listed down in the drop down menu. So in this case, we have imported an EPS file without spot color, so without a spot white or a spot white, a spot varnish colors. So in this case, we can select spot settings. We use white one, under color, for example. For varnish, let's say we do a varnish layer over the full substrate. So substrate, click OK. If you go to the output channel preview, which is new here, and go to preview output channels, you will see the output preview of all channels. So in this case, we have our sign layer, our magenta. You can as well combine channels, our yellow channel, black channel. And in this case, because I have selected the under color option for white, you will see it will output white under all color. Same for white too. And for varnish, we have selected substrate, so it will fill the entire artboard, let's say, with a varnish layer. If we change the spot setting, for example, to variable undercolor, you'll see the preview of the white output channel will change to a variable undercolor for white printing, meaning variable undercolor, this will use less white under darker colors and more white under light colors. This will make a very nice relief, like small 3D relief in your printout. This is a very nice option to test on the device, and you will see a very nice outcome of this one. Of course, we have imported the file here in Production Manager directly. So we import the file in Production Manager. There are some options in Flexi, which will help you designing the artwork. So we have some white and varnish options. First one is the effects underbase, solid underbase, and variable underbase. So this will add an extra layer in a spot color below the image, as well for the finisher. This is a finisher layer for varnish purposes. Let's say we want to use spot colors. We want to define our white elements as a spot color, so we can define it later in Production Manager to print white. So for example, we have our SAI logo here. I'll select it. I press D, selection only, and I select my RGB white, and I can, what I can do is I can change it to an underbase spot color, for example. If I go to Rip and Print now, of course, select the correct color mode. Flexi, to restart Flexi here. So I open the file again. Change this to an underbase. Let's say we make an EPS file. Import in Production Manager. Love it when it crashes like that, Lee. Mostly it crashes when the webinar, when we have the webinar, and the rest of the time it just works perfectly. So So I'll open the file. And in the separation step, you will see the underbase layer. So we'll have to map this one, double click, to our white one channel. If I go to the printer options and spot settings, we have our spot color selected. Now, if you go to output channel preview, you will see only our underbase, the SA International logo, is outputted as white. So with this method, you can really select different elements in your artwork to define it as your white spot color. This does not need to be called spot white, but it can be underbase, just need to be a spot color. Just make sure in the separation step, you link the spot color to your white one or varnish layer in this case. Ariel, I have a question from Ariel. White one is the same as white two in the preview. Yes. As we have selected spot settings, same as white one, it will use the same values for white one and white two. What we can do is we make an extra element. So let's say 100% natural. We can make it underbase or call it underbase 2, for example. So I make a new one, underbase 1. And here I have just underbase. Can import a file. So in this case, I can combine different types of white printing. So for white one, I can select, for example, undercolor. For white two, I can select variable undercolor. So you can mix different types of white and varnish printing. So in this case, I have underbase and underbase one. Import the file in Production Manager. Double click. Output channel preview. So we have to go to the separation step first. Link underbase 1 to white 2. Link underbase to white 1. In the driver settings, spot settings, we select white 1 spot color, white 2 spot color. And now you'll see white 1 is only the logo and white 2 is the text here. Of course, this is not for every driver the case. Some drivers do have only one channel or one varnish channel. So you really have to make some tests before really go 100% production here. Also have some documents for white and varnish printing, which I will provide at the end of the webinar. This is just a text documentation with all the different types, how to set up the overprint and so on, as we have to ignore the overprint, needs to be unchecked for overprint methods, of course. So in Rip and Print, you will find the overprint in the third tab. Okay, it always crashes here because it's looking I think it's looking for my printer, but I don't have the printer connected, so the software will crash here. Okay. Of course, you have, when you import the files in Production Manager, you will have an option which is called choke or bleed. So you can add an extra white bleed to the print as well for varnish. So let's say I want to bleed out a 1 millimeter, 0.1 millimeter white spot color. I can set the bleed and the choke options in the color management tab in here. We can do this as well in FlexiSign in Flexi itself. So if we select our label, let's say we want to select our text, we go to effects, we add an underbase. So let's say solid underbase. In Design Central, you can set this manually as well. So you can bleed or choke your spot color underneath your print. Okay. Does someone needs extra information? Anyone has questions here regarding this workflow? So import file in Production Manager, select the color mode. You can select your choke or your bleed for white. You can set your spot settings of the machine. Don't forget to map, if you have a spot color for white, map the spot color to your channel and check the output channel preview in the new tab, output channel preview. Anyone has questions here? Okay, no questions. I already make a WeTransfer link for the information which I have talked about now. White printing. Okay, so in the chat box you will find a WeTransfer link, with all the information regarding white and varnish printing, the basics. So not for the new layer printing, this information I will provide later in the webinar. So I have a question of Jeremy. For the 800W, 3-layer and 5-layer white are set up the same. Yes. So the 5-layer printing is 3-layer printing in this case. So you can set up a 5-layer print document using 3-layer printing color modes. Correct, Jeremy? Not correct. Okay. Lee, yes, we can schedule een HP layer. We have an HP specialist in the company who can as well, or if you can contact Jeremy, if Lee and Jeremy, if you can exchange your contact details. Voilà. I think Jeremy has more experience because we don't have our the machine yet in the office, so we could not test all the layer methods. So for me, it was very difficult to understand all the workflows in this case. So thank you guys for exchanging contact to contact each other. Thank you very much. Gloss printing varnish with Muto. I think this is those options are visible in the driver options. If you open the printer options, you have as well have the layer printing here. And don't know for gloss which settings you will. I don't know where to change this gloss option. No, I don't know if this is possible here. Okay. So new in version 21. So if, okay, just to mention for the HP, for the new HP Latex machines, you're able to contact, in this case, Jeremy for your questions. Thank you very much, Jeremy, for helping here. Thank you very much. As well, you can contact support mailbox. We also have all the information. As well, for we have a video printing white in Flexi 21 edition on our YouTube channel as well. I think we have another useful preset video. So we have two nice videos for, especially for Flexi HP Edition 700W and 800W. And Jeremy, the output preview you showed doesn't appear in my Flexi 21. I'm in build 3441. To be honest, it should be there for all drivers, so there is no limitation. Okay, let me double check, Jeremy, and I'll send you an email. I'll note down your email address. Okay. Perfect. Let me know via email if the option is there or not, or we can get in touch. Okay, next. So version 21 has some extra layer printing features. We have the layer printing and the Adobe Illustrator layer support. So for the first one, we can, for the layer printing, we can simply add in this case, three files. We can add three different files, but they need to have the same dimensions. So I import three EPS files. We can select the three files, right mouse click, and we can create a layer job. So if we select all the jobs, we can create a layer job, and a pop-up window will open. And in this case, we can link every file to a color mode. So in this case, file one, I print as colors. File two, I will print as white one. And file three, it will print as my varnish layer. If I press OK and double click the job, you will see a sort of three-layer job preview, as well as a new tab here, the layer tab, with the information of the with all the mapped channels. Same here, make sure you have the color mode selected and the correct spot settings for the white and varnish printing. So this is a new feature in 21, so you can import multiple files with the same size, and you can create a layer job of these jobs. As well, we have a new feature called Adobe Illustrator Layer Support. So I have made a file in Illustrator. I will show a preview of my layer window. So I have my print layer, my varnish and white layer, so separate layers, saved as an Illustrator file. I can add the Illustrator file in Production Manager. Okay. I can right mouse click and split job by layers. So if we import this Illustrator file, it will detect the layers of the file. So in this case, my layer was called white, so I'll select white as my print mode. My layer one was called varnish, so I select varnish here. And my print layer, I select colors. If I press OK, this is now a multi-layered job, which as well now can be printed as a layer job. So if a lot of customers are designing in Illustrator, they can simply define different type of layers, split the job by layers in Production Manager, and define every layer to a color mode. As well here, we need some testing, okay? Every driver is different, so you can start with a small job, send the job, see how it outputs. If you think there's something not going well, please contact support. We can take a look with TeamViewer and see how the printer outputs the layer jobs. Ariel, in the new layer function, I don't see the color preview, correct? So if you double click, no, you don't have the output channel preview when creating layer jobs. So only for jobs, single jobs. So if I add a job here, okay, for example, this JPEG, go to the color modes, white. Of course, I am not using spot colors because it's just a bitmap. Go to driver, spot settings. I select, for example, variable undercolor for my white. And substrate for my varnish. So So it will fill the whole image. If I go now to output channel preview, you'll see a nice variable undercolor for white. So this only works for single jobs. Of course, for the new AHP LaTeX series 700W and 800W, there is a lot more preset work, but in the YouTube video I've provided in the chat box, you will see already some nice presets for the sandwich mode, for the overflood, underflood. So this all works with different type of presets. But very useful in the YouTube video, we'll have the different sections. So if you want to use the sandwich mode, you go to the sandwich mode section. You will see which settings you will need to apply in Production Manager. And afterwards, it's just opening a job and send it with the correct presets. Okay, I think this is it. So there are a lot of ways to work with the white and varnish and layer options in Flexi 21. So you can manually set up your spot colors in Flexi. You can add your job directly in Production Manager, but then you don't have the spot colors if there are no spot colors available in the file. So you'll need to set up the spot color as spot underscore white in another design software, and so on and so on. Any questions here? Okay. No questions. So if you have any information, please contact support. If you have a printer driver or the new HP LaTeX 700W and 800W, and you'll need extra information for white and varnish and layer printing, please let us know so we can help you with TeamViewer to set up the Production Manager. Of course, if you have a reseller, HP reseller, contact your reseller. We will set up your device. As well for upgrades and upgrades to the latest version, please contact your reseller or SA International for direct upgrades. Okay. So to make a long story short, we have a very nice workflow for white and varnish layer printing in Production Manager. It's very easy when you set up your file correctly. So go over all the tabs I showed you. So the color management tab, make sure you have the correct color mode. The ignore overprint is selected. As well, if you are designing in Flexi and you select the finisher, for example, you add an extra layer for your varnish, effects finisher, rectangle finish, for example. Make sure so if you select your finisher, make sure you have overprint selected here. So it will overprint your color and your varnish. So if you have a color underneath your finisher layer, you need to select overprint and ignore the overprint and rip and print. So it will print both layers. So the color layer and the varnish layer. I have a question of how to increase projection on image. I'm not sure what that means, the projection on image. Can you describe what you want, please? Thank you, Katja, for your feedback. For me personally, as application specialist, I don't have much experience with white and varnish printing, so I'll try to understand the new machines with all the modes. Of course, there are so many different types of media with different types of white options, so there is a lot of information for this. So these are really the basics. Like, for example, if you add a file and you want, for the white layer, you want less white, you can, for example, go to your color adjustment tab, go to your white one, let's say input 100, so 100 input as white, but I want to output only 80%. So these are all parameters you can set for less white, for more white printing, and so on. Okay, so I think this is it. I don't know if anyone has questions here. Lee is asking for, can you contact me, Lee, via email so we can discuss which driver and so on. So varnish is a protection layer as well as a relief layer to add to your image for more detail, more contrast, more protection. It depends, of course, which media you're using, but you can make nice relief look and feel using varnish and white, especially if you use the variable undercolor for your white option. You can really make nice prints, especially when using transparent media, clear vinyl. You should really test it. Okay. So I think this is it. Hopefully this was a bit clear for you all. A lot of information was already known by the resellers, but I think this is a very nice way to show the different types of white and varnish options as well in Flexi as in the production manager. Okay, I want to thank you all for attending the webinar. Be safe. And I wish you all a very nice day. Thank you.